I don't know these officials, I don't think.
Barely know them myself. One guy, the head guy, is
the head guy, I know.
Jeff Clark, you know Clarky. The other two, I don't know who's who.
Jeff Clark is the black guy?
Yes.
I know him, at least his name.
Yeah. The other two, I don't know.
Are your levels okay in your
ear? Yes, yeah, they're fine. Good.
Benny, how are we sounding? Levels okay? All right, thanks, buddy.
Good job, Benny.
Benny
and the Jets.
Benny's back.
In the blue Benny and the Jets.
Benny and the Jets. Good evening, everyone, and welcome into the Bob Carpenter Center. Good to be back home after a two-game road swing. Sent Delaware down to North and South Carolina, and Delaware comes back with a 1-1 split of those games at UNHW and Charleston. Tonight, the Delaware Blue Hens, with a record of 12-7 overall, 4-2 in the CAA, host James Madison. They're 9-9 on the season, 2-3 in conference play, but winners of two in a row. I'm Scott Klatskin alongside Bill Harmon. Benny Pinella back in the studio. He's our in-studio host and producer on the evening. And Bill, an important swing of games now for Delaware. You come off with a split on your first two road swings of the season. Now you got a chance to pick up some wins at home. Three in a row coming up this, the first against a good James Madison team.
Defense of your home court is imperative in a season that goes through in the CAA. It's very difficult to win on the road. Delaware's done a terrific job, as we've already chronicled here and Martin has talked about. So you come home, you can't feel too comfortable, as I mentioned earlier in the show. You've got to make sure you're totally engaged, locked into the game plan. A very, very competent opponent in JMU, who I think is playing extremely well. They're actually going to start a little different lineup tonight at us. So it'll take a little bit of an adjustment for Delaware. They had prepped for another player, but Dwight Wilson, they're really big guy who's an excellent rebounder, will be back in the starting lineup. So Delaware's got a real challenge. We're going small as well. Eric Carter will be confronted by Wilson. Should be a fun matchup to watch down low, Scott.
Let's get you those starters, brought to you by Delaware State Education Association. DSEA standing strong for student success. Nominate an all-star in education by going to WDSD.com and clicking on contest. So the starters for James Madison, coached by Lou Rowe in his third season, 29-54 overall. It's a young lineup. It's three sophomores, a freshman, and then a fifth-year senior. That fifth-year senior, Stucky Mosley, their leading scorer at 15.7 points per game. Matt Lewis, Darius Banks, we chronicled their sophomore campaigns during the pregame show, but the second and third leading scorers on the team, respectively. Deshaun Parker, a freshman, he'll play some point guard, 4.5 points per game, but nearly three assists per contest. And the man that Bill Harmon just referenced, Dwight Wilson, a 6'8 sophomore, their leading rebounder at 8 per contest. For Delaware, led by Martin Inglesby, his third season, 39 wins as the head coach of the Blue Hens, four of them coming against James Madison. A new lineup for the Hens. They'll go with four guards. Matt Vareto will come off of the bench tonight. Ryan Allen, Kevin Anderson, Darian Bryan, Ithiel Horton, the guards, and the man in the middle is Eric Carter, 9 rebounds away from passing Alex Coles, a legend here at Delaware, on the all-time rebounding chart. Assistants for Delaware, Bill Phillips, Corey McCray, Torian Jones, Pat Rogers on operations, and he did a heck of a job operating, getting this team home safely from Charleston on that road trip. And Danny O'Connor, the label says director of a video or whatever the title is. Danny does a little bit of everything.
Boy, Danny is a huge component of this team. I love Danny. He's really been great with us in the broadcast crew. A terrific young man who I think is going to be a very fine coach. And you're right, Pat Rogers got you guys out of there in the nick of time. You might not have gotten back till Tuesday or Wednesday
he was,
with that weather.
He was magnificent, to say the very least.
Delaware, glad you made it back,
too,
partner.
That's right. Everyone's home. We're ready to play some basketball. And so are the two teams. Ready to tip off. Carter and Wilson will jump it. Delaware going left to right as we see it at the ValleyDaysFuel.com broadcast table. And as Eric Carter usually does, Delaware wins the tip. And they've got the basketball first. Delaware wearing their home white uniforms. They blue Delaware across the chest. Yellow trim James Madison. Their road purple uniforms with a gold JMU across the chest and white trim. Allen on the three to get things started from the right wing.
Boy, just too easy out there. Not played very definitively there by JMU, who looked confused defensively. They had Wilson, their big guy, out on the perimeter, and Stucky Mosley was underneath. Stuck, excuse the pun, on Eric Carter down low at a great start for Delaware.
They go into Banks underneath. Right-handed hook over Eric Carter is through. 3-2 as both teams have scored on their first shot of the game. Delaware ran that set to Ithiel Horton, the shot that Ryan Allen made to get the first basket of the game against Charleston. Things went downhill from there against Charleston. Hopefully not the same result today as Allen misses from the same spot on the wing left side.
A great look. Wilson was trying to close him out, and the step back provided a lot of space. That's a good look for Ryan. He'll keep shooting that. Delaware opening up in 2-3 zone, as Martin alluded to in the pregame show.
Wilson nearly traveled, lost his footing, missed the shot as he backed down Carter on that right block using the right hand and shot the basketball over the rim. Anderson into Carter, his first touch, spins left, moves his pivot over to Allen, splits two, gets inside, flips to Carter. Beautiful pass and a better finish by Eric Carter.
And I love the assist by Ryan Allen as he shot faked, got off the three-point line, got into a wonderful spot, didn't get too deep. There was a help up involved. Drops it off to Eric Carter, who did a really nice job there with his footwork and his faking action to score.
That's what we were talking a little bit about, Ryan Allen penetrating the defense of James Madison. He had 23. Against Charleston, did Allen a season high. Mosley inside to Banks, mid-left block, takes one dribble to the right side, and forcing the miss was Eric Carter. Won't get credit for a block, but his hand was there to rearrange Darius Banks' shot. He starts one of two. Delaware leads 5-2. We're 2 minutes in to the first half.
Though Eric Carter's not known as a shot blocker, he is a shot effector, and he's very mobile in there, actually moving much better than he has in the past. Gets around shots just to change the arc.
17 block shots on the season, to his credit. Carter now offensively to the right hand, and if he does not get double-teamed, we've seen this all year, Bill, it's either going to be a foul or a bucket for Eric Carter.
That's a great point. They have double-teamed him more in CAA play. That's why his shooting percentage is down a little bit, and he's been forced to pass out. That time he was able to back down Wilson with the dribble, and then that last dribble is really hard, goes up into his left shoulder, right-handed jump hook.
It's 7-2, Delaware leads. It'll remain that way as Mosley shoots a contested three over Darian Bryant. High hand by Bryant affected the shot a bit, and Delaware with the basketball down the floor for Horton. Horton, a straightaway three, pull-up jumper, nothing but the bottom of the net, and it's 10-2.
Typically, JMU double teams when the center's involved in a hard hedge action on ball screening. Right now, they're not doing that, and again, Wilson caught on the shooter and couldn't close him out. Ithiel Horton with a great look.
Hens have made 4 of 5 to start. Parker with the basketball against his zone. Delaware looking good on both sides. Matt Lewis's first touch. We're over 3 minutes in. He's the team's second leading scorer. Here's Mosley, cut off by Bryant. 5 seconds to shoot for Parker. He dribbles in, float shot over Carter, touches nothing. He gets it back, tries again, and misses. Carter can't corral the rebound, but into the hands of Darian Bryant. Horton wants to push, sideline right. Picked up by Matt Lewis as he gets across half court. Inside out dribble to the left side of the basket. Flips one up with the left hand. 5 in a row for the rookie of the week.
I'm surprised JMU doesn't take a timeout here. They're off to a really slow start. They're not defending very well. Delaware getting their great looks and also getting to the basket. A great drive there. The use of the left arm, but his inside arm holding off the defender. Ithiel Horton allowed himself to get to the basket.
12-2 is the count. 16 minutes left in this first half. A hot start for Delaware. James Madison with the basketball. Lewis shoots the three as Allen's slow to get back up after stumbling, but Lewis shoots it over the backboard. Now running the floor is Carter after the rebound. He gets fouled, and he'll shoot two when we come back. Doesn't get much better than the start for Delaware. 12-2 at our first break against James Madison. We'll be back in a moment. Carter up to 6 points, lead the way. Horton has five. Allen with three, the first basket of the game. And Delaware leads 14-2 after two free throws made. First substitution of the game for James Madison, as they've got Zach Jacobs in the game. Leads the team with 22 blocks on the year. Banks playing that four position, passes out to Mosley. Mosley off the mark. No one boxes him out. Almost got his own rebound near the three-point line, but Allen tracked it down eventually into the hands of Anderson.
The shot was so offline that it rebounded out so far that Delaware's guards had to actually dig out to get the rebound. It was such a bad miss.
Inside to Bryant with the flush. Right-handed from Kevin Anderson. Nice look inside.
Delaware not only is playing well, but it looks like they're really having fun. A lot of smiles out there, not only because they're off to a good start, but they're sharing the ball, they're defending, they're rebounding, doing all the little things to get them off to this great start.
It's also pretty fun to be on a 13-0 run. That's where Delaware stands now. 16-2 as Lewis gets in close, shot over Carter, falls, and that stops some of the bleeding. Over the last 3 minutes and 30 seconds, Delaware had a 13-0 advantage. It's now 16-4, Delaware on top.
The sophomore had to elevate over and upraised arms by Eric Carter. Really nice finish there by Lewis with a soft using the backboard shot.
Here comes Carter against the smaller Jacobs, but a good shot blocker backing him down on the left block. Takes him inside. Head fake, spins to the right hand, an array of moves. None of them stopped by Jacobs, and the basket through for Carter.
Three different fakes there by Eric Carter, never losing his poise, not rushed at all. That was a magnificent low post spectacle down there in terms of his footwork and his attention to detail.
How about the patience by the senior? Stucky Mosley gets the free throw line. Kick out Parker, fading, hitting on the three for James Madison. And they've scored on back-to-back possessions for the first time today.
Parker plays at a nice pace, never rushes his shot, always takes a good shot, understands what his team needs him to do.
Now a strip. Anderson turns it over. Parker, the man we were just speaking about, gets down the floor, plus one. He stripped Anderson and then scored on the other end. And Parker, great back-to-back possessions both offensively and defensively.
As Kevin was bringing the ball down the middle of the court, which is exactly where he should be, he just tried to cross over. It was a little high and a little slow. Parker has excellent hands for a freshman. Read the crossover move. He probably watched some tape on that. Positioned well and then actually played through some contact to finish. So, as you mentioned, two really good plays here by a young player finding the right moment to make some plays to get his team at least back within shouting distance.
And Anderson had a pivotal turnover as Delaware was trying to come back in it against Charleston, dribbling the basketball and not being careful with it. He's got to learn, and he will, as he continues his young career here at Delaware. Free throw good, a 6-0 run for James Madison, and now just an 8-point lead for Delaware. They led by 14 just moments ago. It's 18-10, 13:30 left in the first half. As Anderson dribbles high, crossover on Phillips. Loretto's into the game for Horton. Back to Anderson. He drives on the big fella to the rim. Wanted contact, didn't get it, but a tip is in from Eric Carter. And Eric Carter already in double figures.
Well, they had a shorter player trying to block him out, Mosley, and then Carter did a great job of extending his right hand, getting it widespread to control that tip in.
Mosley with the basketball now for James Madison. He's been shut out on 2 3-point attempts. Corner goes to Parker, back up to Banks. They work it against this 2-3 zone with Allen and Anderson on top. Bryant, Carter, and Vreto on the back line. Phillips, cross-court pass to Parker, bounces into Banks. Banks beyond the arc to Stucky Mosley. His three sails again. Mosley has not touched the rim on 3 3-point attempts. This is one of the leading 3-point shooters in the CAA. A 10-point lead for Delaware, 20-10. 12:36 to go. First half is Anderson has the basketball at the point guard position. Allen, jab step, drives on Phillips to the cup. Underhanded layup is through around the big fella.
He had the 6'9 redshirt senior on his back, and he found a very creative way to go up just at the last moment. Phillips played that to block the shot, but could not. A crafty play by Ryan Allen.
Allen and Phillips as Mosley glides to the rim, tries to get a little closer and misses. Foul is on the floor against Delaware. Allen and Phillips both from Bowie, Maryland. So I wonder if they've seen that play a little bit outside of the college realm. They probably played in high school, or at least some recreational basketball against one another, coming from that same area with a lot of talent in Maryland.
A good sub there by Lewis Rowe. He gets Mosley out to kind of settle him down. Three almost air balls on 3-point shots, and then a floater that really didn't have much of a chance. get him out and allow Greg Jones, another sophomore, to come in and get some minutes here while Mosley rests, but really more importantly, settles down on the bench.
Phillips gets Goss in the air, waits for him to settle, and scores with the left hand. Phillips not a big scorer at just 4.5 per game, but he challenged Goss, who subbed in for Eric Carter. Anderson gets it across half court. Parker picks him up with a score 22-12. Bring it over to the right side. Picks up his dribble to Bryant, who picked up the foul last time down the floor. Anderson with a jab step. Goss sets the screen to the left. Phillips on the switch. Anderson to Bryant. Bryant wing right. Foul line corner. Vareto catch releasing on a three, and it's in for Matt Vareto, his 28th three-pointer of the year, second most on the ball club.
JMU hard hedges the ball screen. We drag the ball screen. We reverse the ball. Darian Bryant then attacks before the defense can recover. And then, since the defense is so spread out after the hedged ball screen, he kicks it through to the corner to Vareto, wide open shot.
Parker flat on a three straight away. His miss landed right on a Delaware player and went out of bounds, which will bring us to a timeout. 11:08 remaining in the first half, and Delaware's lead is 13, 25-12, 10 already from Eric Carter. We'll be back in a moment.
That was actually a really, really good play there. That's something they talked about. That they dragged the ball screen, like I described, and then they quickly reverse it. Now the defense is off center because there are more players over to the left. Bryant drives it because there's no help.
Yeah.
And then as the defense recovers, you get a help ball for the deep corner, and that's why Vareto was wide open. I mean, that was really good execution of a play. I guarantee you they worked on the way they play the ball screen.
83% from the field.
Not a bad start. Not a bad start.
Do you want that, or do you want to describe the
No, I already described. Let's talk about some. What do you want to talk about?
Just the team just looking about as loose as we've seen them to start a basketball game.
I mean, absolutely.
Even the games that they've won, they went down 12 against William Merrick.
Early.
Here we go. Sorry. Welcome back in to the Bob Carpenter Center in Newark, Delaware. Good to be home, and the Hens are enjoying playing on these home rims. 25-12 is the start. 11:08 left in the first half, and Delaware shooting 10 of 12 from the field. They are 83%, while James Madison is shooting 36% against this Delaware 2-3 zone. Let Acme be your one-stop shop for everything winter. Stock up on soups, hot beverages, and ingredients for your favorite meals like Lancaster brand meats. And don't forget the firewood. Acme, your favorite local supermarket. I got a feeling people will be heading to Acme with some possible snow coming in this weekend here in Delaware. And it is just a phenomenal start for the Hens. About as loose as we've seen Delaware start a game this season.
I mentioned that they really seem to be having fun. It really is fun when you see shots fall. But the reason they're falling is because they're getting excellent looks. Ryan Allen understands how they're playing him on those screening action. He stepped back for one wide open shot. Another one that looked. job of getting everybody a touch in these possessions, reversing the ball, skipping it a little bit, using some ball screen action. Really like the heady play by Ryan Johnson coming in off the bench.
Missed shot by the Hens. Johnson keeps it alive momentarily, but out of bounds will be James Madison basketball, down by 10, 25-15, and 9:17 left in the first half.
JMU's defense now sharpening up a little bit. Martin Inglesby going back to his bench. Horton and Ryan Allen come back in. A little bit more scoring in off the bench. JMU is fairly predictable. They're going to hard hedge with their post player anytime his man is involved in the ball screen. They'll do a lot of switching otherwise, but they were not sharp at the beginning of the game, yielding so many good looks for Delaware.
Horton and Allen back in on top of the 2-3 zone. Carter will enter after the next whistle. Phillips, he's been on the attack offensively, trying to go at Colin Gosson for the second straight touch. He's gotten Gosson with a reach-in foul. That's the second on Colin and the fourth on the Blue Hens.
And a good sub here. Martin will get Colin out and bring Eric Carter back in. When you play that post player who's
ball when we return. Delaware up by 10. 27-17. Hens lead with 7:37 left.
and more of this 2-3 zone. Their slides are getting much better. Their angles are better. They're doing a good job of cutting off any drive penetrations by JMU.
Mosley has a lane, kicks to the corner. Banks drives, left baseline, gets in close, misses. Phillips on top, and he misses an easy putback, but a foul after Phillips then grabbed the rebound. If I'm Coach Rowe right now, I'm really enthralled with the effort I'm seeing by redshirt senior DeVell Phillips, who only has 2 points, but 3 rebounds in 6 minutes of action. He has really been effective in this game. He's drawn 2 fouls on Colin Goss as the inbound goes to Matt Lewis, and he gets one off the window and in.
Lewis is a really smart player, very athletic, very savvy, uses the board an awful lot. You can tell he was well coached in high school and obviously here with Lewis Rowe.
And a foul is Anderson dribbled from left to right. We talked about this a bit last year, but Matt Lewis was on the radar for the University of Delaware. They offered Matt Lewis a scholarship to play at the Bob Carpenter Center. They've got a pretty good eye for talent, the Coach Inglesby and his staff, that's for sure. Even the ones that don't end up committing are really solid basketball players. And, of course, on their way to probably 3 rookies of the year in a row.
I would say that's stellar recruiting.
That's pretty good stuff. Anderson, he's trapped, gets it to Allen, guarded closely by Mosley, 13 to shoot. Jab step, Allen trying to get it inside of Carter, does so. Ball stolen away, good defense by Jacobs, gets the turnover. That's just the third by the Blue Hens as we get to the 6:30 mark in the first half. Delaware up 27-19.
Eric just didn't look like he was quite ready to catch that pass from Ryan Allen on the direct. He's just got to have his hands ready at all times to catch any sort of pass, whether it be a bounce, an air pass, or a lob.
10 to shoot for James Madison. Into the corner, Mosley's have a rocky start to this one, 0-4. On top to Jones, 3 to shoot. Foul line, shot over Allen. High off the window, off the mark. Rebounded by Ryan Johnson. Hens want to push. Sideline left, it's Anderson across half court. Picked up, 3-point line inside. It goes to Carter. After a pass from Ryan Allen, backing down Jacobs, baseline left, and the reverse is through for Carter. He has been unstoppable on the block. 5 of 5 from the field.
Patience, knowing where the defense is, feeling the defense with his body. There's been no help at all. Jacobs playing behind, just getting back down. Good use of going to the weak side to use the rim as a shot block protector.
Carter, 12 points, 3 rebounds, 11 minutes. Mosley, 0 of 5, and that foul line jumper from the left elbow, I might give him credit for it grazing the rim, but I'm going to say Mosley's taken 5 shots and has not touched the rim.
I think you're right on that. Mosley just looks very tense here. I mean, he's an experienced player, played at Toledo. He's been an excellent player, non-conference and in the league games, though his scoring, as we mentioned in the pregame show, dropped off a little bit. Once we got to conference, teams are defending him a little bit more intelligently, but he's way off his game at the moment.
Double figures 44 times out of 50 games for James Madison is Mosley as Carter drives baseline on Jacobs. Jacobs, solid defense. Carter continues to back him down. Passes out to Anderson. Wide open loop for Kevin Anderson. It's strong, and he has really struggled from beyond the arc. Just to finish the point on Stucky Mosley. 1 of 8 shooting against Towson last time out. 0 of 5 to start this basketball game.
That was a great look from Kevin Anderson. We'll take that shot every time. Eric did a nice job there as he got double teamed, kicking the ball out to a wide open Kevin Anderson.
Cross-court pass, Allen steals it. He's going to dribble down the floor, off balance, off the mark. Carter, an offensive rebound. Putback is short, and Banks will take it the other way. Does not have numbers, doesn't seem to mind, and goes coast to coast.
Boy, he can do that. We call that a bust-out dribble. Gets the rebound, attacks. He knew he had Kevin Anderson in retreat. What was really special about that play, he was in a full sprint and then was able to gather his body up and release the ball very softly. A lot of players then just take a wild shot, not Banks.
29-21. Delaware led by as many as 14, now 8. Carter with the basketball as we approach the 4-minute mark. Working on it, Jacobs. Right past him, too easy.
Jacobs was working hard to take away the top shoulder, his left shoulder, where Eric loves from the right side to get into the middle. Eric realized that immediately, drop step, used his left hand on the baseline, an excellent move.
Lewis, an elbow jump shot on the right side. I like his game, the sophomore from Bishop O'Connell.
Boy, those two sophomores we talked about, Lewis and Banks, they're very steady. They play at a good pace. They never seem to get flustered. They take good shots. Excellent players along with our young players as well. This is really a great chance to showcase these young men.
9 points for Lewis. Allen, there's another sophomore for 3. Short this time. He made his first. He's missed his last 2 from long range, but he's got 7 points in the contest as Lewis driving on Allen. Allen gets a block shot along the baseline, and a foul on Jacobs after Allen secured the basketball. Delaware doing it on both ends. We'll take a timeout, our final one of the first half. 31-23 is Delaware's lead on WDSD.
Clorox disinfecting wipes kill 99.9% of germs and help keep the memories going even through the sneezy months. Stock up on Clorox disinfecting wipes today for a clean and healthy home during cold and flu season. Clorox. Clean is the beginning. What comes next is everything. Use as directed on hard, non-porous surfaces.
Klondike Kate's Restaurant on Main Street is not only the home for the Blue Hens Basketball Coaches Show, but also the place for amazing specials. Visit on Mondays for half-price burger night. Take part in the Newark tradition that is half-price nachos at Kate's every Tuesday. And remember, wear your Blue Hens gear to Kate's on Sundays from 4 to 9 and receive 20% off your bill. See all the incredible specials and menu items by visiting KlondikeKates.com. Klondike Kate's on Main Street, a proud supporter of Blue Hens Hoops.
This is Blue Hens Country, 94.7 WDSD.
Here in Newark, Delaware, the Blue Hens, 12-7 overall, 4-2 in the CAA, 6-3 at home, trying to defend their home court once again. They got off to such a hot start, led by 14 points at the 14-minute mark. Now we're at 3:27 left in the first half, and the lead is 31-23. I'm Scott Klatz alongside Bill Harmon. Got to be pleased with the many things in this first half. Offensively, shooting 59% from the field. Defensively, holding James Madison to 37%. Maybe one of the best first halves we've seen, certainly in conference play by the Blue Hens.
We've gotten a lot of great looks. Going into Eric Carter has been very important and very successful. Ryan Allen got us off to a good start. We've been sharing the ball, running nice stuff on offense, understanding how JMU is defending us. And at the other end, the 2-3 zone, I think, has gotten better and better as the season's gone on. As I mentioned earlier, the slides are solid. We've done a good job when we leave the middle open of closing that up and digging in and making it hard for players to score in that mid-range. I think one of the most improved players on the team defensively is Ryan Allen. He did a great job there of closing off Lewis, giving him absolutely no angle on that last attempt, and then the foul by Jacobs gives the possession back to Delaware. But Ryan Allen, we talk so much about his offense, but he's an underrated defender, very engaged tonight.
Delaware with the basketball, 3:19 to go, first half. As we resume action, they're going to try their best to get the ball into Eric Carter every time. Jones trying his very best to deny that basketball, and he was holding on to Eric. Greg Jones at 6'7", 220. Carter a bigger frame, and Jones knew.
Well, when you play behind a good post player by Eric Carter, and then he gets you out in space, the officials can see it more. You can never displace the player. That means move him off his spot. You can be there to ward him off, but you cannot move him. A nice call there by this officiating crew.
Anderson with the shot clock at 20 off the inbound, straight away to Horton. Horton, a jab step. He had five in a row, remains at 5 points in the game in 12 minutes of action. Leans in from the elbow off the rim and into the hands of Darius Banks for James Madison across half court. Pushes it to Stucky Mosley. We've talked about his struggles thus far today. Lewis dribbles in against the zone. Head fake, fadeaway off the backboard and off the mark. And Kevin Anderson, really good rebounder at 4.5 rebounds per contest. He's the second leading rebounder. Got another one there from that point guard position. Under 3 minutes to play first half. Delaware's lead 31-23. Right block this time. It's Carter backing down Matt Lewis. There's a mismatch. Double team comes. Bounce pass from Eric Carter to Bryant. Extra pass to Allen. Open look into three. That's great ball movement.
Compress the ball to the baseline of the big man. Kick it through as they start the double. Make the extra pass to a wide open Ryan Allen. Wonderful ball movement, great sharing of the ball, and understanding what that defense is doing to try to stop you.
And it starts with Carter passing out of the double team. Not every big can do that. We saw that a little bit with Devontae Kaycock a couple games back at UNCW. He's a solid player, but he's not half the passer Eric Carter is out of the double team. Lewis fading, hitting in rhythm over Eric Carter. A little smack on the buttocks for Eric Carter as they both walk down the floor. I think more so saying nice defense there, Eric.
The scouting report on Matt Lewis is he's going to take some really tough long-range shots. Once in a while, they're going to go in, but we did a great job of extending Eric Carter and contesting that shot. Just better offense.
Jones held up again, or holding on Eric Carter again, his second foul. And that is his seventh foul against James Madison, so Carter will shoot the 1-1. What more can you say about Eric Carter? 14 points in this one, 6 of 7 from the field. And I talked to Coach Inglesby, we both did, in the pregame show. Talked a little bit about in conference play, Carter shooting 47%, down from 65% in non-conference play. But you're playing teams that are familiar with you as Carter makes the first of the 1-1. And it's going to be harder. You're playing guys like Harris from College of Charleston, Kaycock, Knight from William Mary. The competition goes up a little bit. But when he does not draw a double team, he has nearly been unstoppable from that left block.
You're absolutely right. Eric plays at a nice pace now. He's taken much better care of the ball. He plays to his strengths, which is his left shoulder turn. But he's had some nice counter moves when that's been taken away.
16 points after the two free throws. He's perfect from the line on four attempts. Delaware's lead back into double figures at 36-25. 96 left on the first half clock. They go into Banks. He's been quiet. Parker has not. A three-point shot is in from beyond the arc on the right wing. And Parker has 8 for James Madison.
Parker, a very selective three-point shooter. Not known for that, but he takes good shots and he makes just enough, right around 40% to begin the conference play. Delaware in that 2-3 zone's got to extend out a little bit more now that JMU's starting to get a feel.
Anderson, an open look he had it from three-point range, but not comfortable right now from beyond the arc. Bryant, he is. Corner look at a three is good for Darian Bryant. And another make from long range for Jelly. The tri-captain makes it 39-28 and a timeout taken by Coach Rowe and the James Madison Dukes. And Darian Bryant has added that element to his game this season. He shot 26% from three a year ago. He has made 40% of his triples over the last 15 games.
He looks so confident. He's comfortable. He uses his legs better. He's always had a nice release, but at times his shot would get a little flat, and I think that was just because of his, at times, little lack of shot preparation. Now he's prepared. He's catching to shoot. What was beautiful there is it went around, and there's Ryan Allen, a terrific three-point shooter. And he had a decent look, but he made the extra pass to the corner where Darian Bryant was wide open. Wonderful sharing of the ball, understanding the team concept by Delaware. Ryan Allen, I think, playing as well as he has all season right now.
Look at some of these guards. Allen, 2 assists. Anderson, an assist, and 3 assists for Darian Bryant here in the first half. James Madison with the basketball. Lewis to the rim, runs into Ryan Allen, gets a shot up. They call a foul on Allen, although Lewis was out of control a bit. I don't think Allen was set defensively. And the foul called against Allen is his first.
If Ryan had just gotten a little lower in his stance and had been stable, now you can technically be moving and still get a charge call for you, but in that case, the movement was at a different angle, and that's what created the foul. Looked very awkward there as Lewis drove down, and he was clearly ready to either travel or draw the charge. Ryan was working hard to come around from the weak side and confront him, but just a little late.
A rare miss from the free throw line for an 81% free throw shooter, Matt Lewis. He makes his second. I misspoke. The timeout a moment ago was called by Martin Inglesby. His team up by 10. 39-29 as we go under a minute. About a 14-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. 20 to shoot for Ryan Allen. Deep left side, and it goes to Bryant now. As he dribbles right to left. Guarded by Banks, dribble handoff to Allen. He'll center it. 9 to shoot for Allen. Has his man off balance. Inside to Carter. Mismatch. Banks defends, but not well. Eric Carter to his left hand. He's got 18 first half points.
Typically, JMU double teams the ball screen where Eric Carter's involved. They did not. Mosley gets on Eric Carter's back. Just a gigantic height advantage. Eric using his left hand to score.
Mosley, another shot, missing everything. And into the hands of Eric Carter, his fifth rebound to go along with 18 points in the first half. And Delaware will walk into the locker room with a 41-29 lead. That's about as good as you'll find a Delaware basketball team play in this season.
Shooting well, sharing the ball, making good decisions, playing excellent defense, keeping the team off the glass, JMU off the glass. Eric Carter got a big rebound and contested 2 inside shots there, so they couldn't cut it to 10. So that was a really good finish to the half by Delaware.
41-29, the count at the break. We'll take a timeout when we come back. It's the IBEW Local 313 halftime report. Benny Pinnell is back in the studio. He'll have scores, news, and notes from around the world of sports. Then we'll come back with first half stats here at the Bob Carpenter Center. Delaware leads 41-29 at the break. We'll be back in a moment.
To Delaware basketball on the
Welcome back here to the Bob Carpenter Center. Big thanks to Benny Pinello for taking care of our Blue Hens halftime report, presented by the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers Local 313. Great start to this one for Delaware back home after a two-game swing down south to the Carolinas. 41-29 the score at the break. I'm Scott Klatskin alongside Bill Harmon, bringing this to you on 94.7 WDSD and iHeartRadio. Let's break down those first half stats brought to you by Dash In, where you can get any size coffee or cappuccino for only 99 cents, made with 100% Arabica beans. Their coffees are bold, smooth, and rich. Fall in love at first sip with Dash In coffee, any size for only 99 cents. Find a location near you at dashin.com. What a first half by Eric Carter. 18 points, 7 of 8 from the field. He missed a fadeaway tip-in that he was trying. Other than that, perfect. 4 of 4 from the free throw line. He has 5 rebounds, and now he is up over 200 rebounds on the season. He joins Mike Daum of South Dakota as the only player in the country with 300 points and 200 rebounds on the year. Mike Daum, for what it's worth, a Wooden Award midseason top 25 finalist. So a pretty impressive company for Eric Carter. 17 minutes of action for the senior. 10 points for Ryan Allen, coming off a 23-point performance against Charleston. Also 3 assists for Ryan Allen. 5 points for Bryant, 5 for Horton, and 3 for Verretto. Gets Delaware to 41. Shoots 62% from the field and 5 of 10 from three-point range. James Madison, on the other hand, they've been led by Matt Lewis. Really like watching this youngster from Woodbridge, Virginia. 12 points, 5 of 9 from the field in 20 minutes of action. Other players in double figures, but Parker, our first look at him, and Deshaun Parker, the freshman, he's got some talent as well. Starting for the 4th straight time, 9 points on 3 of 6 from the field. 4 points for Banks, 2 for Jones, 2 for Phillips. The story for James Madison has been the struggles of Stucky Mosley. Not only is he 0 of 6 from the field, I don't know if he's touched the rim on any of his shots. He has shot the ball long over the backboard, over the rim on each of his 6 attempts. And Bill, that really tells the story of just how well this Delaware defense has played in the first 20 minutes.
Delaware's been playing all 2-3 zone. We did show one possession of a 2-2-1 three-quarter court back to the 2-3 zone. What it's done is threefold. One, we've limited JMU's outside shooting to 37.5%. We've done a good job for the most part of extending, locating shooters, chasing them off the three. We've also been able to keep them out of the lane, getting to the basket, where they've been very successful. They've averaged over 21 free throws. They've only taken 3 so far in the game. And also in playing the zone, we've done a good job of keeping ourselves out of foul trouble. Only 6 personal fouls in the first half. Colin Goss, the only one with 2. The two negatives are we haven't created a lot of turnovers. JMU averages 14 a game right now. They only have 2, and they've gotten 7 offensive boards. But that hasn't really hurt us. So look for us to shore up that offensive rebounding aspect from JMU's standpoint. Get some more bodies in there and make sure that weak side of the zone is defended.
Delaware the basketball first as we are underway here in the second half. Delaware 41-29 lead. And Eric Carter has it at the foul line. Backs out to the three-point arc. Ithiel Horton with the basketball. Dribbling right to left. Gets into the paint. Kicks it out to Bryant. 8 to shoot for Darian Bryant. Back to Horton. Beyond the arc. A 3 is on the way. Front rim no. Tip out all the way back to Horton, who tracked it down near half court.
Good job there by Delaware to chase down the long miss by Ithiel Horton. JMU almost playing a little bit of a soft man-to-man. It resembles a 2-3 zone. It might even be a little bit of a matchup at the moment.
Corner, Anderson. Left side, he'll bring it back out to the wing against his zone. Inside a Horn, beautiful look by Kevin Anderson.
On a matchup zone, if you cut someone, you can identify whether it's zone or not. It was. He gets wide open on the left side of the block. A great find and a fine finisher with the left hand by Ethan.
8th assist of the game for the Delaware Blue Hens. He averaged 13 on the season. 18:53 left to go on a 43-29 lead for the Hens. Park with the basketball on the wing for James Madison. Lewis, good look at a 3 from the wing. Strong, and a rebound into the hands of Delaware's Ryan Allen. He'll flip it to Horton. Anderson, Allen, Horton, Bryant, and Carter, the starters for Delaware as they started the basketball game in the first half. Parker, Mosley, Lewis, Banks, and Dwight Wilson starting for James Madison as Carter gets to the free throw line, stops his dribble, back door to Jelly, flips it up off the mark too strong and into the hands of Banks, but a good look by Eric Carter.
Nice back door there by Darian Bryant, a fine pass by Eric Carter, as you mentioned, a good push at the other end. Mosley gets off in transition. That's where he's most dangerous. Delaware's got to locate him a little sooner and not allow him to put the ball on the floor towards the basket with his left hand.
He just made a shot along the baseline. Still hasn't touched the rim. That time it went through the net, though, for Stucky Mosley, making his first shot And Delaware's lead is 43-31. Here's Horton with the basketball. Screen set by Carter. Horton picks up his dribble. A pass in front of the Delaware bench. Jelly has it. He drives in the paint. Kick out. Anderson, five to shoot for K.A. Leans into one from 10. Strong. Tried to follow his shot, but couldn't get to it. Now Mosley on the run for James Madison. Mosley all the way to the cup. No one stopped the basketball. He misses on a layup. Ball is loose. Parker gets it for James Madison. Corner. Mosley again. And he's got five straight after the corner triple.
A hustle play by Mosley to force the ball down the court. Took a little bit of a questionable shot, but it gets run down and a quick pass by Parker to a wide-open Mosley. Delaware's got to locate Mosley. He's one of these shooters, is a momentum player as well.
And a 10-second violation by Delaware as James Madison putting on the full-court pressure. Anderson stood for a moment behind the half-court line and just one tick too many for Delaware as they could not get it across, and the violation makes it 43-34 in James Madison's basketball.
A little bit of trapping action there by JMU to pick up in front of the timeline. Kevin's got to have some help. We've got to have somebody in the middle, maybe another trail guard where you can go back and then get it over.
Just the fourth turnover of the game for Delaware. As you mentioned, James Madison only with two. Clean basketball game in that regard for both teams. Banks, he's got to get going. Shot over. Carter was forced and missed with the right hand. Rebound for Eric Carter, his sixth, on his way to another double-double. If he can get four more boards. Inside it goes to Carter. Mismatch easy over Banks. That was over Mosley. And this small lineup by James Madison on some switches. Carter's had several mismatches against guards. Another one there.
And he's had Mosley four times against him. Even though that was zone, Mosley got stuck down below the baseline there to have to defend.
Mosley warming up here in the second half. He got a look from the wing right side and knocks it through. He's got all eight of his points in the first 3.5 minutes of this second half. And it's 45-37. James Madison cutting into what was once a 14-point lead for Delaware.
So when Mosley starts getting hot, you've got to extend on him, change the relationship of where he is when he catches the ball versus the defender. We've got to be more extended, force him to put the ball on the floor.
Bryant inside, trying to get it to Allen, but a pass is defended by James Madison. Now Parker on the run to Banks, a good three-point shooter. In and out over the back goes Phillips. First foul on James Madison in the second half.
Well, good job by Delaware blocking out that time on the zone to get Phillips to come over the back. So a nice adjustment at halftime of doing a better job of blocking out your assignment in the zone.
James Madison playing better in this second half of basketball. They trail, though, still 45-37. Hens on top, 15:56 to play here in Newark. Back in a moment on 94.7 WDSD.
Radio.
Back here at the Bob Carpenter Center, where Delaware leads 45-37. Mix it up and order any two or more Domino's medium two-topping pizzas, specialty chicken, stuffed cheesy bread, spread twist, or marbled cookie brownie for $5.99 each. I'm Scott Clapton alongside Bill Harmon. And Bill, we're looking at Coach Rowe and his James Madison team making some adjustments as they need to do to start this second half.
Rowe, who played at JMU for 2 years, an all-conference first-team selection his senior year, played for Lefty Drizel, a zone coach who really liked to make changes at halftime. Coach Rowe has learned from him, did a nice job of, I thought they would do some different things in their man-to-man, Scott. They've gone to the zone. They're trying to take Eric Carter out of the game, or at least minimize his effectiveness by clogging up the inside and not allowing his easy entry passes, and a little bit of a three-quarter press here to distract and distort Delaware's assault, and it did create one turnover.
It did. Horton slicing through, though, as they get it across half court and now into rhythm offensively. 17 on the shot clock. We played four in the second half. Anderson at the free throw line over to Allen. He squares, fires, and hits. Ryan Allen's got three of those and 13 total.
And Delaware readjusts themselves. Kevin Anderson at the top of the zone is a great passer. Look low to Eric Carter. That got the zone to compress. Kicks it back out to Ryan Allen, wide open on the right side at the arc.
Now Mosley open on the other side for a three. A miss into the hands of his teammate Phillips, and that'll reset the shot clock on the offensive board. Mosley gets it back. Baseline jumper this time from 10. Hits every part of the rim and falls, and Sucky Mosley has 10 second-half points for James Madison.
Good job there by DeVelf. Phillips running down the rebound, not panicking. Gets it to Mosley along the baseline where he's really good off the dribble. Delaware's got to contest him.
Inside Carter, you can't forget that guy. He was open underneath and power slams it through.
Anytime you come on one side of the zone and turn away from the defense to the weak side, you always have a numbers advantage. A good find there by Ryan Allen to Eric Carter for the dunk.
It's 50-39 after the 22nd point for Eric Carter. On the dribble drive, Lewis blocking foul against Darian Bryant, trying to take the charge on the sophomore guard for Bishop O'Connell. I said 10 points in the second half for Mosley. I should have phrased it all 10 points in the second half for James Madison, as it was 29 points for James Madison at the half. Now they're up to 39, all thanks to their redshirt senior.
Darian Bryant trying to get in the way there of Lewis, just a little late again. Matt Verretto in here to give Delaware a little bit more size on that back line.
Third foul on Delaware. And Bryant's second. No one in foul trouble for the Hens. Phillips inside against Carter. He goes to his left. Carter fouls Phillips hard. And Phillips will shoot two. Not a bad foul, sending one of the worst free throw shooters, I would think, in the country. I was gonna limit it to the conference just because I unknowingly don't know the stats around the nation. But at 38%, you've got to assume there's not many worse than this guy.
I think that's probably pretty smart of you.
Now, he'll go on to make both, I'm sure.
And his stroke actually looks pretty good, so you can just tell it's concentration. A nice move there by Phillips as he went in with his left shoulder in the middle. Eric took that away, and then he immediately reverse pivoted to the baseline.
Isn't that the case? He made both free throws. It's always the case when you say how good a free throw shooter is, they'll miss two, and when you say how poor they are, they'll make two. And Phillips did just that. A 9-point lead for Delaware. 50-41 is the lead for the Hens after Phillips, who's been playing tough in today's game. 4 points in 10 minutes, but five rebounds underneath. Reto back in. He gets it at the foul line over to Bryant, wing left. Carter is double teamed, baseline left. Brings it back out beyond the arc. 10 to shoot to Anderson in the quarter. Carter is beyond the arc. He's got 7 to shoot. Anderson with 6 around the arc. 4 seconds inside to Verretto. Verretto, his shot blocked by Phillips on the reverse, and it goes back to James Madison. A 9-point lead for Delaware. Parker with the basketball, picks it up to Lewis. Lewis, wing left, in the corner to Banks. Banks inside to Phillips, working on Carter. Phillips to the right hand, he draws the foul for the second straight possession. He'll go to the free throw line. The foul that time on Eric Carter, the fourth on Delaware, and the second on the senior.
Phillips, not a big scorer, but he's really made some excellent hustle plays. He's been tough on the boards, run down some long misses by JMU to afford them a second chance. And now he's showing a little bit of offense, getting into the lane, using that 6'9 frame against Eric Carter.
He's been playing better offensively over the last three games. 18 points over his last three games, but he's made 8 of 11 over the last three games coming in. He's one of two today from the field. Misses both free throws there. And Delaware's lead remains 9, 50-41. Carter with the basketball at the elbow left side. Takes one dribble, bounce inside to Verretto. Verretto on the reverse, gets it through this time with the assist coming from Eric Carter.
They high-load the 2-3 zone. Eric Carter operating at the top of the foul line, attacks, draws the middle man of the zone up. That leaves Matt Verretto wide open underneath, who finished. The last time he played just a little fast. Next time you're contested, use a fake. That time he was free and went right up.
Lewis inside, finds an angle, well defended by Kevin Anderson, but Matt Lewis up to 14 points on 6 of 11 from the field. And we mentioned this guy averaging 20 points per game in CAA play. He's on his way there in this contest. 52-43, Delaware with the basketball, bounce into Carter. Carter left it for Matt Verretto, but a steal by Matt Lewis, and he's flying up the floor. Delaware stops basketball as he gets to the right block. Back out to Parker. Parker, he'll drive past Verretto, and he reaches around the rookie to get a basket. Two very talented freshmen going at each other on that possession, and the lead just 7 for Delaware.
Parker is really clever in and around the basket with using both hands and long underhand scoop shots a la John Stockton.
I like the timeout here by Martin Inglesby. We'll take a break with him. 12:28 left to play. James Madison getting closer. Delaware's lead is 52-45. We'll be back in a moment on 94.7 WDSD and iHeartRadio.
It's for free Kasasa checking at American Spirit Federal Credit Union with locations in Middletown, Dover, and right down the road from Delaware Stadium in Newark.
I'm going to do the
American Spirit.
Going to do the radio. Yeah. Good.
Klondike Cates on Main Street in Newark is the proud home of the Blue Hens Basketball Coaches Show, presented by First State Orthopedics. Join men's basketball head coach Martin Inglesby and women's basketball head coach Natasha Adair at the next show on Monday, January 21st at 7 p.m. for great food and fun with Delaware Hoops fans. Klondike Cates is the place to be every other Monday at 7 p.m. The next show will be January 21st. It's the Blue Hens Basketball Coaches Show, presented by First State Orthopedics, live from Klondike Cates.
Come experience a new direction in healthcare with UD Health on UD Star Campus. Visit udel.edu/star/UD Health to learn more about a new direction in healthcare.
Chevrolet of Dover, the best deals, best selection, and a free lifetime warranty. Chevrolet of Dover, where you get treated like family. Find new roads at Chevrolet of Dover.
This is Blue Hens Country, 94.7 WDSD.
A 52-45 lead for Delaware, 12:28 remaining in the second half of basketball. Fans, the SL24 Memorial Basketball Classic in honor of Sean Locke to benefit his foundation and efforts to create awareness for mental health is coming to the 76ers Fieldhouse on February 8th. Please mark your calendars. It's a quadruple header between Ursuline Academy versus St. Mark's JV and Varsity Girls and St. Mark's versus Sally's JV and Varsity Boys. Sean Locke, an alumni of St. Mark's High School. The classic will help to celebrate Sean's life and share his story in partnership with the Mental Health Association in Delaware. For more information, go to 76ersfieldhouse.com and click on events. Our good friend Sean Locke, and we miss him so much. Please go to 76ersfieldhouse.com, click on events for more information on an outstanding event.
Scotty, I have the great honor to serve on the board with a number of really fine people. Chris Locke running it, the father of Sean Locke, and the outpouring has been tremendous. The organization has done a fantastic job getting this ready, and there's still plenty of time to contribute.
We miss Sean, and he'd be proud of Delaware's effort tonight, that's for sure. Right now up by 7 points, and missed by Ryan Allen gives James Madison a chance to cut in even further. Delaware led by 14 to start this second half, or at one point in the second half. Mosley's had a better second frame, 10 points after starting 0 of 8. He's made his last four. Over to Lewis. Phillips with the basketball at the elbow left side. A pass to Banks, elbow right. Driving on Carter to the rim and scoring. And Delaware's lead is just fine.
A lot of patience by JMU. They did not panic when they got down. They've stuck to their game plan. The switch to the zone has been successful for them. Eric Carter there a little reluctant to challenge after a couple quick personal fouls.
52-47, 6-0 run for James Madison. They've made each of the last four shots. Allen looking for an answer, driving the lane, getting contact. Basket doesn't fall, but Ryan Allen, who has made 9 in a row from the free throw line over the last two games, will shoot two more when we come back. This is the 12-minute media timeout at 11:26 remaining. Ryan Allen will shoot a pair when we return. 52-47, the Hens lead at the bottom.
At Dashin, you can get any size coffee or cappuccino for only 99 cents. Yep, any size coffee or cappuccino for just 99 cents. Made with 100% Arabica beans, our coffees are bold, smooth, and rich. And for a limited time, we have pumpkin spice cappuccino, a seasonal favorite. Fall in love at first sip with Dashin coffee. Any size for only 99 cents, just 99 cents. Find a location near you at dashin.com. That is dashin.com.
Now at Acme, you can save more money and earn rewards. Sign up today for Acme's digital coupon and rewards program just for you. It's exactly how it sounds, featuring personalized deals and rewards that are just for you. As a Just For You member, you can earn rewards to save on grocery purchases or to save on your gas purchases at participating Sunoco stations. You'll also find lots of money-saving digital coupons. Not signed up? Just download the Acme Markets mobile app or visit acmemarkets.com for complete details and start saving today. Acme, your favorite local supermarket.
Welcome back to Fightin' Blue Hens Basketball on 94.7 WDSD and iHeartRadio.
Welcome back here to the Bob Carpenter Center. A portion of this broadcast brought to you by Brandywine Electronics. Visit BL.com for all your audio needs. I love working with the folks over at Brandywine Electronics for over a decade, powering all broadcasts on 94.7 WDSD for the Hens. James Madison on a 6-0 run over the last 1 minute and 41 seconds. I'm Scott Clapton alongside Bill Harmon. Delaware got to get things going again offensively. Perhaps a trip to the free throw line for Ryan Allen will help things out.
We talked so much early on in the show about Ryan Allen's ability to play at different levels on the court, not relying on the three-point shot, and that was great evidence there that he's learning his lessons well. Drove in, attacked the bigger player, Phillips, drew some contact because he was being aggressive, and they ended up keeping the call on Phillips, which is his fourth, and that's a big loss because he was giving them great minutes.
He's been playing aggressively. Coach Rowe, I had some complaints about who the foul was as we went to the timeout, and Allen makes his 10th free throw in a row, and you knew Ryan Allen's free throw percentage would rise as the year went on. He made just 7 of his first 14 free throws, but now 11 in a row over the past 3 games. He was 7 of 7 against Charles.
Just too hard to believe that he could shoot below 70% with that stroke, and now he's getting his confidence, working a little bit more, and I think that part of that is his layoff.
Delaware, after the media timeout, in a man-to-man defense. They've been playing that 2-3 zone most of the way, or all of the way. Ryan Johnson on Banks. Near half-court screen comes from Jacobs. Banks on the switch, defended by Carter. Carter staying with him. Banks on the dribble drive. Leans over Carter. That stellar defense by the senior, forcing the miss from Banks underneath. As we go under 11 minutes to play, Anderson with it inside. Hop step. That's a blocking foul by Jacobs. I chuckle a bit because it looked like there should have been some type of variation of a travel, as there was two hops that I saw, but he landed with 2 feet both times and got the contact from Jacobs.
That was not the Euro step. I'm not sure what step that was, but maybe a dub step. But fortunately, a foul on Jacobs as Kevin Anderson initiated good action attacking, draws the foul.
54-47 is Delaware's lead. The third foul on James Madison. Carter to Anderson. Clear path to the lane as Lewis fell, but Anderson cannot make the free throw. Rebound comes into the hands of Darius Banks, and Mosley's dribbling down the floor. Banks gets Allen off his feet, drives the lane, left baseline, floats up with the right hand and a miss. Rebounded by Ryan Johnson, giving great minutes off the bench as he's been doing in conference play.
Both teams switched back out of that timeout to man-to-man. JMU actually now back to zone, but they played man the last time down. That's what afforded Ryan Allen or Anderson with that great drive.
Johnson flashes to the free throw line, drives baseline, kicks out Allen. Open look. The lefty three is connected, and Allen points to the crowd to celebrate the make.
You talked about Ryan Johnson making the kick out pass to Ryan Allen, wide open at his perfect spot on the left wing, foul line extended.
Mosley sails a three on the other end. That's 5 in a row for Allen after JMU cut it to 5, a 10-point lead for Delaware, 57-47. Here's Horton's turn, a 3 off the mark, and a rebound by Eric Carter. He was held up by Jacobs, and the foul will be the 4th on the Dukes.
Eric Carter did a really nice job there of understanding that Horton was going to go up into that shot right away. Got himself positioned. Jacobs had nothing he could do but force his hands out to keep Eric Carter away from the weak side rebound. So good positioning by Eric Carter draws another foul against JMU.
Anderson will go to the bench. Bryant into the basketball game, joining Horton, Johnson, Allen, and Carter. A 10-point lead for Delaware. Allen, foul line, jumper, and Ryan Allen's got 20 for the second straight game.
Delaware sets a pin down screen, a down screen on the weak side. Ryan Allen reads it perfectly, curls as a smart player would since the defense was trailing, gets wide open in that mid-range. Excellent offense by Ryan Allen.
How about Allen? 20 points, 5 rebounds, 4 assists in the contest. Delaware back up 12, 59-47, a 7-0 run, all for Ryan Allen. And Matt Lewis, Stucky Mosley ends it. And a timeout taken by Lou Rowe. We will stay right here with Delaware up by 10, 59-49, 9-10 remaining. And let's go back to Ryan Allen because he has just been phenomenal over the past couple games. 23 points against Charleston, 20 today. We talked a lot about Eric Carter, but really anybody, not anybody, but several guys on this team can get you 20 points in a game. We've seen Ithiel Horton go for 31, Ryan Allen, Eric Carter can do the same. And Allen doing it from every level. We talk about the threes, but the pull-up jumper from the free throw line a moment ago. Outstanding.
He's gotten to the basket. He's gotten to the free throw line. He's only taken 11 shots and has 20 points. That's incredibly efficient. I love the fact that he's got 5 rebounds and 4 assists and no turnovers, playing really good defense with only 1 personal foul. So that's about as good a line as you can have. And I really like the engagement of Ryan Allen. Kevin Anderson has done a really nice job of distributing the ball. He's out on the bench at the moment. But I like the fact that he's been coming in, giving Delaware really good minutes, an excellent passer against that extended zone that JMU's playing.
James Madison's timeout will give him 2 left for the rest of the day. A 10-point lead for Delaware after the Mosley jump shot. All 12 of his points have come in this second half. Horton with the basketball. Phillips in again with the 4 fouls. Allen, 3-pointer on the line in front of the Delaware bench. He's got 5 3-pointers and 23 points for the second game in a row.
That's just bad slides of the zone to leave the hottest shooter on the court wide open in front of the Delaware bench. Good job with the ball reversal. No one contested Ryan Allen's shot. Very confident now, rising right up in his shot.
Mosley does the same, rising into a 3, and Stucky Mosley's 3rd triple makes it 62-52, Delaware on top.
Mosley's one of those players that is a catch, ready to shoot player, so you've got to be there even closer to him, jam him, force him to put the ball on the floor.
Allen trying to get it into Eric Carter against Phillips, who has 4 fouls. Carter, left block. 13 to shoot as he works against DeVell Phillip. Up and under move, spinning twice to his left hand. He spun 1 too many times, moved that pivot, and the traveling violation against Carter.
As he made 2 fakes into the middle, he tried to slide back with a step under move to his left, and unfortunately, his pivot foot moved slightly. That was a good call. Pretty good defense there by DeVell Phillips, who stayed straight up and forced Eric Carter to make multiple moves in the lane.
Horton going to check out. He wasn't feeling well all week or part of this week and played a whole lot of minutes. So thus far,
just a couple practices with some intestinal flu symptoms, but battle back and be ready to play as much as he has tonight. A real credit to the young man.
Mosley, a contested 3. Mosley, whatever was hurting him in the first half is not in the second half, as he has 18 second half points, 4 of 9 from 3 overall. And James Madison just won't go away. 62-55 is Delaware's lead as Carter takes it to the cup on Phillips, spinning, scoring with the right hand.
That was really a clinic there as Eric Carter got the ball out almost at the 3-point line in front of the bench, did some extra dribbling, no help at all for Phillips to defend Carter, who then drop steps to the baseline. A really great job in ball handling.
Lewis pulls up from 10, missing, rebound Johnson. The graduate student from Mercer giving great minutes. And Eric Carter telling his team to settle. Anderson will do so as he brings the ball up the floor with a 9-point advantage, 64-55. Carter in the 20-point range for the 6th time this season. Bounce pass, he's trying to add to it, and a blocking foul is called against James Madison after the drop-off pass found Carter in the lane. 7:04 left to go, and we'll take a break from the Bob Carpenter Center. Carter's got 24, Allen's got 23, and we've got a lot of basketball left. The 94.7 WDSD.
According to a recent...
Excel Business Systems is the official business system partner of Blue Hens Radio and iHeartRadio Delaware. Excel Business Systems is a company with more commitment to their customers from creation to destruction. Excel is our single trusted partner for all of our office and document management solutions, especially for all of our game day printing needs. They got us, our color charts that we like to have here courtside. For more, visit Excel Digital. Hens.com. I'm Scott Claxton. Pleasure to be alongside Bill Harmon back here at the Bob Carpenter Center. And a pleasure to watch this basketball team play. 64-55 the lead for the Hens. But credit to James Madison. There were some points in this game where it looked like Delaware might run away with it, and they have not, mostly in part to Sucky Mosley, who had no points at the break and now is at a team-high 18.
Well, he's been the main factor why they're back in this game. Even though he has not shot it particularly well throughout the game, he got hot here. He's a streak shooter. Delaware's got to deal with him. 4-for-9 from the triple. Darian Bryant, when they play man-to-man, will draw that assignment.
Carter at the free throw line, where he misses the first. His first miss from the stripe. 4-of-5 today. He's barely missed in the game. 10-of-11 from the field is Eric Carter, one of the most efficient players in the country. 17 points, 10 rebounds per game, and shooting 60% from the field. He's the only player in the country with that stat line. He does miss both free throws there, and a chance for James Madison to cut further in. 64-55, the Delaware lead. Darius Banks, quiet game, 3-of-10 from the field. He passes off to Mosley and Jones, an illegal screen, obvious call for this officiating staff. 6 foul on James Madison, and Jones picks up his third.
Delaware goes to man-to-man as they've been playing the last couple possessions. As I mentioned, Darian Bryant on Mosley was right there on the catch, and as Mosley tried to use the ball screen, it was still moving towards him because of Bryant's great pressure. That affected the play, and that created the offensive foul with a block.
Across half court, James Madison pressures, double teams. Anderson with the basketball, center circle. He'll operate with 20 on the shot clock and a 9-point lead. 6:30 left to play at the Bob. Carter dribbles with his left hand, picks it up, flips over to Allen, who has 23 points. Backs out, Phillips defends. Allen has the big man off balance, pulls up from the foul line, off the rim and off the mark. Into the hands of Stunky Mosley, who will bring it up the court. He's 4-of-9 from three. Mosley, the team's leading scorer, at just under 16 points per game. He's eclipsed that at 18. Phillips, right block, defended by Carter. Backs him down. Carter is going to be, no, it's going to be Phillips, who will be fouled out thanks to Carter taking the charge. What a heady play by the senior.
Eric Carter understood that Phillips wanted to get into the lane, so he got on the top side on the right side, which meant that Phillips was dribbling with his left hand, not as adequate, to his right shoulder and draws a big charge. Phillips, who's given Coach Rowe and JMU some great minutes tonight, fouling out.
You might have heard Eric Carter on our mic. We heard it sitting here. I love the attitude of Eric Carter. Yelled, come on, White, let's go, trying to fire up his team after taking the charge. Now talking to Ryan Allen out there on the floor. There's a leader. There's one of your three captains showing why he is in charge of this basketball team. Coaching
still,
as we look
still
at
still being him. Very demonstrative, yeah, with Ryan Allen, telling him how to slice cut, I think, and how to get Eric the ball in a certain spot that he wants it. Really good job by the senior to work with all the players. Not only is he a leader physically on the court, but leader verbally in a good way.
Carter fouls out Phillips. And Phillips, that line won't look like much offensively. 4 points, it'd have 8 rebounds. But he was aggressive. He played very well, I thought. Had a great energy that he added to this basketball team. And now Jacobs, who has struggled defending Eric Carter, will have to play against Carter the rest of the way unless they bring in Wilson, who started this basketball game but has not played much. 8 to shoot for Bryant. They go to Carter. Carter turns and faces on. Jacobs blows by him to the baseline left, and no one can stop Eric Carter tonight. He is 11 of 12 from the field.
Still confused why JMU is allowing their post player to play one-on-one without any help as Eric Carter continues to dominate. Played through Jacobs's contact there with a great finish on the left side with his right hand.
He is special to watch. 26 for Carter. Bank slicing through, draws contact on Anderson, and we'll go to the free throw line. Just the fourth foul on Delaware this half, but I believe he'll say Banks was in the act to shoot.
Going back to the point about the way they've been defending Eric Carter, they tried some zone, which was successful, and then they left Ryan Allen open a couple times. Then they go back to man-to-man, but they continue to play him behind, allowing him to get the ball in great spots and then attack without any sort of distraction from another helper.
I apologize. They said foul on the floor, so the inbound pass. So now we'll see a foul in the act of shooting as Mosley drove the lane and drew the foul against, I believe, Darian Bryant, third on Jelly, who, night in and night out, Darian Bryant is asked to defend the best player on the team that they're playing. Tonight it was Stucky Mosley. Shut him down in the first half. Mosley's gotten his way. Obviously, the zone helped in the first half of basketball, but just so impressed with what Darian Bryant does. Doesn't care if he scores 5 points as he has tonight or 25 points. He is a lockdown defender and really a glue guy on this team.
Yes, he certainly is. But what I like about him is his attention to detail. He understands exactly what's written in the scouting report and then can take that information, translate it to the game, and make really efficient and effective defensive plays.
Mosley makes two free throws. 66-57 is the Delaware lead. Delaware's made four of the last five from the field. James Madison hasn't made a shot in 3 minutes of action, but they're making some from the free throw line. Johnson trying to get it into Eric Carter. They do so. Left block, working on Jacobs. Double team comes. Six to shoot is Carter. Retreats to the three-point line. 3 seconds and a timeout taken by Eric Carter. I understand the decision, and we'll stay right here with 4:45. I understand the decision of keeping the possession. Carter was in traffic, but now you burn a timeout, and you're still not going to get a good shot off with two on the shot clock.
I think so much of it is the position on the court. The ball is going to be right in front of us at about 35 feet here. If it was underneath, you might be able to run a more effective play. And I think, unfortunately, Eric had his back turned to the basket, so he knew the clock was running down, but I'm sure if he'd known it was 2 seconds, he wouldn't have taken it. Not a great decision. You understand why he wanted to do it, to preserve possession. But with so little time left, it's going to be problematic that we get off any kind of decent look.
Join myself and Matt Janis for the next Blue Hens Basketball Coaches Show, presented by First State Orthopedics, live from Klondike Cates on Main Street. The next basketball show will be this Monday, coming up January 21st from 7 to 8 o'clock. Please join us at Klondike Cates. Great show. Great fans every other week. We're there at Klondike Cates for the basketball show. Coach Adair, Coach Inglesby, myself, Matt Janis, and some players as well. January 21st from 7 to 8 o'clock. Remember, on Sundays at Klondike Cates, wear your blue and gold and get 20% off your bill. 2 seconds for Carter. Inbound pass is stripped away from Carter. And so a turnover after the timeout by the Hens, and Darius Banks with basketball dribbling down the floor, gets the layup up and through, and now Delaware's lead shrinking once again at 66-59 after the layup.
We tried to go into Eric Carter off the inbounds. Unfortunately, the pass was a little off center and forced Eric to jump off his feet, and then he lost his balance. And then at the other end, good job by Banks to attack Carter as he was trailing him down the court. So good offense there and good defense by JMU.
Anderson dribbles right to left. Between the legs, dribble, picks it up at 8. 7 to shoot for Allen. Trying to get space from Parker. Pulls up. Not much space. Not much needed for Ryan Allen, who's got 25.
Tough shot off the bounce, but he elevated over Parker to score.
Inside, Jacobs was lost defensively, and a timeout by Coach Rowe. We'll take a break with him. Our final timeout here tonight with Delaware up by 7, 68-61. 3:58 to play. You're listening to 94.7 WDSD-FM and iHeart Radio.
The connection is strong.
Got a good one at the Bob Carpenter Center tonight. Delaware, 12-7 overall on the season. Trying to get to 5-2 for just the third time in CAA play since joining the league. Delaware started 7-0 in 2014, and they were 5-2 in the 2008 season. So this could be the third time Delaware's gotten off to this good of a start. They got to close out a 7-point lead. They've never trailed in the basketball game, led by as many as 14. James Madison has not gone away. Taking a look inside the box score, 26 for Eric Carter, 25 for Ryan Allen. All their players in double figures for the Hens. 20 points for Stucky Mosley on JMU's side. Lewis has 14-11 for Parker. Both teams have made five of their last six on offense, and a 68-61 lead with 3:58 left to play.
I'll be interested to see what JMU does out of this timeout, whether they show this pressure and fall back into the zone or show this pressure and possibly play man. But on the last possession, They double-teamed Eric Carter with Mosley, so they ran a guard at him because they're going so small. Here they're in some full-court man-to-man.
Bryant will walk the ball up. Anderson, Allen, Bryant, Carter on the floor along with Horton, and they break pressure. But Anderson is double-teamed. Carter comes and helps him out. He dribbles to the three-point arc and back to Anderson between the circles. He'll operate, but just 12 to shoot for Delaware, up by seven. They run Allen off some screens. Inside to Carter they go. One-on-one with Jacobs, double-team comes. 4 seconds for Carter, 3 seconds. Cross-court pass is stolen away, and Lewis has the basketball racing up the floor, left sideline. Back to Banks, a big three on the way. He connects, and the lead is only four for Delaware.
They did just what I thought. They showed some pressure. They slowed us down. We got the ball to Eric Carter with about 8 seconds. He was double-teamed from the guard opposite the court, so a nice job by JMU with a defensive adjustment.
Allen with 20 to shoot as Delaware breaks pressure. 17 now, Carter at the free throw line. Looking for a guard, it's Anderson. Checks the clock, and Delaware running out of time again. It's in single digits. 8 to shoot for Anderson. Pass back to Bryant. Bryant, 3, is short, and a rebound by Jacobs, down by 4.
Tough shot there by Darian Bryant. He had a chance there to shot fake and maybe get into a better spot. A good high-hand contest. JMU playing really good defense right at the moment with the changeup of running double teams from the weak side guard at Eric Carter.
They're looking good defensively. Can they add more offensively? Lewis on the drive. Bryant blocked the shot, but he got a piece of the arm of Matt Lewis. And that's going to be the fourth on Darian Bryant, a pivotal part of this team defensively with 2:31 remaining.
Matt Lewis does a nice job, especially on the left side of the court, of getting a good angle as he attacks the basket. Never out of control. Almost looks to use the block as a landmark and stays inside that where he can use the bank shot or go immediately to the baseline. Darian Bryant caught on the top side of Lewis, and that's what created the foul.
One possession game after the first free throw was missed by Lewis. Lewis frustrated with himself. He's missed two free throws, 81% on the season. Rarely misses two. Anderson works against the trapping full court pressure. Gets it across half court. Carter has it deep left side. Ball comes loose. Stripped. Out of bounds. Parker touched it last. Delaware will inbound right in front of us with 17 to shoot. But James Madison kicking up that defense over the last several possessions.
Well, Parker took a swipe at the ball. Eric brought it down a little too low. Protect it with your body. Keep it away from the defense. A good play there by JMU. But fortunately, it goes out of bounds off of them. Less time now for Delaware to start a set play here with Eric Carter, sprint screen.
Anderson on the drive, taking Jacobs to the cup, passes back to Bryant. It goes to Carter on the inside, a miss. Carter's tip, missing two times in a row at the rim, and a chance to tie for James Madison. Lewis underneath, a wild shot. The miss is tipped by Carter into the hands of Bryant, and Delaware will walk it up. Martin Inglesby wants to talk to his ball club. They'll take a timeout with 1:55 remaining. We'll stay right here, Bill. I know you want to talk about that last offensive possession.
Well, we're a little out of control. It was very fortunate that it wasn't an offensive foul. I thought there was a good job there by, I believe it was Parker, to step in and draw the charge, but it reversed out. Eric, so many times as a big man, Scott, you just want to keep the ball high and try to tip it in. Sometimes if you're not sure and you can grab it, get it to your chin and then go back up maybe for a dunk or to get fouled. Unfortunately, that time, Eric, who had a nice tip in with an open hand earlier in the game, did not. At the other end, Lewis was clearly driving there to get fouled and did not get rewarded with the call.
Didn't get the whistle. Delaware with the basketball. Timeout taken by Coach Inglesby. A 6-0 run for James Madison. 1:55 remaining. Delaware led by as many as 14. That came in the first minute of this second half. Delaware led 41-29 at the break. They bring it outscored in the second frame, 36-27. A three-point lead for the Hens. James Madison, they've played in close games. Delaware has played in close games and won. Both of these teams know how to finish basketball games. Who will come out on top is James Madison. The game has never been tied since tip-off, and Delaware has never trailed. An important huddle right now for Coach Inglesby is he's got to get his team settled. They seem to be feeling a little bit of this pressure as their lead has gotten down to three, and they've been able to run good sets for Eric Carter. They fouled out Phillips. I think if they get the basketball to him and Jacobs, who has not been able to defend Eric Carter, something good will happen, whether it's a basket or a kick out to a shooter.
Eric just wants to be prepared for that weak side guard's run across the lane at him when he gets it on the left side. rotate the ball right away, and then we're going to have a numerical advantage on that side as the man comes running towards you. One interesting thing here, I thought that was a good timeout by Martin to settle the team down. He is now without a timeout, so that tough one in front of us that we talked about might prove to be pivotal. The arrow in favor of JMU, and they have two timeouts remaining.
Stop stopping and get Easy Pass. Easy Pass is accepted in 16 states, helping take more people, more places fast. Keep moving with Easy Pass. Get your Easy Pass online at easypassde.com. A 6-0 run for James Madison. They've made six of their last eight. Delaware's not scored in 2 minutes and 20 seconds. Horton, Carter, Bryan, Allen, and Anderson come out of the huddle after the timeout, the final one taken by Coach Inglesby. Allen gets the basketball center circle, guarded man-to-man by Stucky Mosley. Screen set by Carter. Allen on the dribble drive. Leans, tough angle, a miss by Ryan Allen on the left side, and a chance to tie with a three for the James Madison Dukes. Delaware needs a stop defensively. They got one last time down the floor. And scoring drought continues, 2.5 minutes. Mosley's had the hot hand of the second half. All 20 have come in the second frame. Basketball now to Mosley. Lewis at the free throw line. Kicks out to Jacobs. Jacobs finds Stucky Mosley, the senior, guarded by Bryant, who has four fouls. Bryant six with him. Mosley, a contested three off the back iron and into the hands of Kevin Anderson. That's a defensive stop they needed.
That was a great defensive possession for Delaware. Team defense, but Darian Bryant in particular with that great contest of Stucky Mosley. Did not lose him on the top ball screen.
1 minute left. Delaware hasn't scored in over 3 minutes. They lead by three, 68-65. Anderson has nine to work as he approaches the three-point arc. Picks up his dribble. Bryant at the foul line. 4 seconds for Bryant. Bryant flips it in using the left hand, and another clutch shot late by Darian Bryant against James Madison. The lead is five, a two-possession advantage for the Blue Hens. 70-65. Parker with the basketball to Mosley, guarded by Jelly. Mosley gets in close. Double clutch layup, spins in, and with 30 seconds remaining, Delaware will have the basketball up by three. A timeout taken by Coach Rowe for James Madison. 0.8, the differentiator between the shot clock and the game clock. So James Madison will have to try to get a steal, and if they don't, they'll have to foul.
They'll show that full court pressure, whether it be the man-to-man where they can quickly trap, or possibly a 1-2-1-1 where they put a man on the ball. They'll go for the steal, as you mentioned, early on in the possession. I don't think they'll let it play down more than 3 or 4 seconds. It shouldn't. You need to allow as much time left for multiple possessions. Try to foul someone that they think is not as good a free throw shooter. Martin will counter here with his best free throw shooters and ball handlers in the game at this moment, because you know you're going to get fouled by them, and they have to. The scoreboard, Scott, says no timeouts left for JMU. On my stat sheet, mine, it shows one. So I believe
they have one.
They have one left.
I think you're right, Bill. Delaware does not have any timeouts left, so if they have trouble getting the basketball in, they cannot call a timeout. And James Madison has been really good with their full court pressure. Free throw shooters, if Darian Bryant is left in the game, he'll be the lowest percentage free throw shooter at 64%. We'll see if that's the lineup that they go with. They probably should, because he's at 64%, but coming off the bench, Ryan Johnson has not shot much from three-point range. Matt Verretto, as good of a shooter as he is, not a great free throw shooter, and they are going to remain with the lineup that they had in Allen, Carter, Bryant, Anderson, and Horton. So if you're James Madison, you want to try to get the basketball to Darian Bryant percentage-wise. 75% for Anderson, 70% for Allen. Carter shoots 75%, and Horton at 80% at the free throw line. But it starts with Delaware being able to get the basketball in. Ryan Allen will be able to run the baseline as he's got the basketball now. 30.8 on the clock. Delaware up 70-67. Allen throws it into Carter. Back to Allen it goes. And he'll dribble the basketball up the court. Double team comes, and he's fouled as the ball was tipped into the hands of Darian Bryant. Almost a steal for James Madison, but as his pass was deflected, he was shoved a bit. And he'll go to the free throw line for a 1-1. Very important trip to the free throw line for Ryan Allen. Allen went 0-3 at home against William Mary from the free throw line, so this is not a sure thing for Allen, although he has made 12 free throws in a row.
In in-game situations, though, I would really trust Ryan Allen, who demanded the ball back from Eric Carter after the inbound. He was the inbounder, gets it to Carter, back to Ryan Allen, brings it up. I was a little surprised that JMU didn't foul earlier on. It looked like Mosley was trying to, just couldn't get the call. Go for the ball, try to strip, get piece of the hand.
Only 5 seconds came off the clock. Allen makes them both. Clutch free throws for Ryan Allen. who has a new career high, 27 points for Ryan Allen, coming off of a 23-point performance against Charleston. 26 was his previous high. Allen leading the way, his team up 72-67. 21 seconds for Banks. The dribble drive, the leaner off the mark. Ball loose. Lewis with a rebound. His putback is strong, but he was fouled, so it was 16.5 remaining. Lewis will shoot free throws with the clock stop.
What they did there was just attack. Banks took a wild shot. He was trying to get fouled at that point of the game with so little time remaining. You're just trying to drive, let the whistle in the official's hands, try to dictate the game. A good job by them hustling on the offensive glass.
Lewis makes the first free throw. 72-68 the score now. Johnson, who is in for defensive purposes, will check out. Horton back in. And again, after Lewis makes the second, Delaware will have to inbound the basketball. No timeouts left. And make what will still be a 1-1. Allen is the trigger man. He throws to Carter. I don't think Allen knew he could move on the baseline as he had his feet set. Allen gets the ball back after throwing it into Carter. And a 1-on-1 coming up once again for Allen. That's the ninth foul against James Madison. So if they get a possibility to foul again, it will be two shots automatically for the Hens.
Good job by Delaware getting it inbound to Carter, who then gets it off to Ryan Allen. A lot of times teams defensively there will leave someone open they think is the worst free throw shooter and then immediately foul them. That's not how JMU played it. They were defending everybody and trying to see if they couldn't get a five-second call, which they could not.
13.4 remaining. Allen at the free throw line. A new career high, 27 for Ryan Allen. Last 1-1 of the basketball game, and Allen knocks it through. He's got 28, 5 of 5 from the free throw line. Really wanted to at least make one here. Of course, the first one, because that makes it a two-possession lead for Delaware. 73-69 with the second free throw on the way. And it's smooth off the hand of the lefty. Ryan Johnson going to check in for Ethiel Horton for defense. Delaware going to go full court pressure to slow down James Madison. Inbound goes to Parker. Delaware up 74-69. Parker across half court to Lewis. 8 seconds left in the ballgame. Lewis pull up three to keep his team alive. A miss. Anderson will be fouled with 3.8. And it looks like Delaware is going to hold on for their 13th win of the season.
A great job defensively by Delaware there in the clutch. Good high hand contest. You probably don't want to allow an easy three, but it was contested. How about Ryan Johnson? That was his seventh rebound of the game. It hasn't been put up yet, but did not score, but two assists and should have six or seven rebounds on the game.
Get a chance to score here at the free throw line to seal it. 3.8 remaining. And Delaware holding on to be victorious against James Madison. And the full court pressure, what it did was it slowed up Parker just enough where even if that final shot went in, it would have been really tough for James Madison to get a good look.
Good design
there.
My fault. It was Kevin Anderson getting the rebound. I thought it was Ryan Johnson.
Parker's final shot for three off the mark. And Delaware leads end-to-end, 76-69 the final, and the Hens now 5-2 in CAA. Just the third time in school history they've been off to this good of a start in CAA conference play. A phenomenal performance from the start to the finish by the Delaware Blue Hens, and a really impressive showing from Eric Carter and Ryan Allen in particular. 29 points for Allen, 26 for the big man.
Great closure of the game, too, making all those free throws. Ryan Allen, very confident. Eric Carter throughout the game did so many big things for Delaware. I thought it was a great effort defensively. The 2-3 zone instrumental in the first half of holding JMU down. It really took Stucky Mosley to have a tremendous second half where Delaware had been able to cruise a little bit more easily. But this was a great way to defend your home court after coming off a big split down south. An excellent team effort.